Alright everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I'm making this video here to answer some questions that needed to be addressed from my last video. The one where I had the fan blowing on a feather inside of a vacuum chamber simulating Martian conditions. So the first question people had was, how am I turning the fan on? Well, you see I've got a couple of magnets here. And one of them has a tilt switch on it. The one inside the chamber, in fact. A tilt switch looks like this. It's a little glass tube filled with a little ball of mercury that rolls around, and then when in this position the mercury is making contact with some electrical contacts, completing the circuit. When I tip it up like this, it's no longer connecting the circuit, so the switch is off. Very simple and quite useful, because now I can just turn the fan on and off remotely. So the next question was, if the Martian wind is not powerful enough to move even a feather, how is it that Mars can have sand dunes and, you know, sand blowing around? The answer is, Mars really doesn't have sand blowing around. In fact, the sand on Mars is going to look a little bit more like this. This is powdered clay. You see, it's going to have very tiny particles, which of course are easier to move. Also, the gravity on Mars is slightly less, well, a little bit less than half of what we have on Earth, and so particles are a little bit easier to move around. So the main question I've seen is whether or not the fan is even blowing, and if so, is my estimate of 10 miles an hour even remotely close? I'll say right now that it's probably a little off because the fan blades are moving significantly faster due to less resistance, but it's kind of hard for me to determine the exact velocity because I don't really have a specialized instrument for measuring wind velocity at such low pressure. But I do have something that will interact with this amount of wind, and that is smoke. After all, the dust particles on Mars are about the size of smoke particles. So if I'm creating a Martian-type wind, I should be able to move smoke particles around. So how do I plan to create smoke? You see, inside this chamber there's no air, so I really can't get a fire going. But I do have a laser that I can shine on a piece of wood from the outside. The heat from the laser will pyrolyze the sugars in the wood, creating gases such as CO2, water, and a little bit of smoke particles. So let's hit this matchstick with my laser and see what it does. There you go, you can see the smoke being produced, and then promptly falling to the bottom of the chamber because the atmosphere is just so thin inside there. Let's try that again. Whoosh! It's cool watching it because the expansion is just so much more vigorous than it is on Earth atmosphere. Let's zoom out a little bit. And there's the smoke falling to the bottom of the chamber. Okay, so now let's turn the fan on and let's see if it is able to blow the smoke around. Fans on. Let's hit this with the laser one more time. And there you go. The smoke is being pulled around by the laser. Fan. I meant fan. You see the smoke is being circulated around, and yet the feather is still not moving. So there you go. Proof that I do actually have wind being produced by the fan. It's able to move the smoke particles because they're just so tiny, but not quite powerful enough to move the feather. So now I know of two more questions you guys are going to ask. First, how does the fan blow at such a low atmospheric pressure? Well, the answer to that is it creates a pressure differential the same way as it does here on Earth. The thing is, the pressure differential is much smaller, but the total atmospheric pressure is also smaller, so it produces about the same wind velocity. And if you think about it, the particles of gas are moving around at about the same speed, regardless of the other particles in the chamber. And so they're able to smack into the wind blades, which are moving about the same speed as well. And so they're going to bounce off about the same speed. So it creates the same velocity. Now, the second question is going to be what happens to the head of this match when I light it inside the chamber. There's no air inside the chamber, so it's not going to catch fire, but there is an oxygen source actually inside the match itself, the potassium chlorate in the match. Of course, I could make an entire video dedicated to just seeing what happens when matches burn inside of a vacuum chamber. So I think I'll actually do that, but for now, I'll leave you guys with a clip of me doing it here. Hope y'all enjoyed. I'll see you next time.